Our celebration of talent, dedication, and joy continues, everybody. And today offers us the lovely opportunity to pour one out for our friend, Felix. Felix the Judge, alongside Hunts and Neutral, bring us yet another fantastic add-on pack, everyone. Felix's Fancy Potions. From status recovery gulps to some wacky wonders, these brews are ready to make their dues. So thanks again, Felix, and to all those involved. I do love me some low-key witchcraft, especially when it extends to and gives us control over the configuration options in the mod menus. From having the ability to enable or disable any of the potions seen here today, to tweaking cooldowns on status recoveries, every single potion can have its overall effectiveness tweaked to your very liking from top to bottom. Heck, we can even make it so bosses drop certain potions too, which is just a cheeky little hidden configuration for ya. Good stuff. However, what is any source of witchcraft without an apothecary station? We all need a cauldron to bubble toil and trouble. So grab some cutstone, logs, and frog legs to get you one. Then the brewing begins, and let us start from the top, shall we? The health potion is concocted via 3 butterfly wings, a spider gland, and 1 red mushroom. And be sure to note that every single potion craft here today is going to equal 3 potions in total for you by default. But when drunk, the health potion restores, health. Wow. Didn't see that one coming, but by default, it's going to recover 20 health a sip. However, also by default, recovery potions have a cooldown of 20 seconds, so it's not like you need to just slam down health potions, folks. But again, everything is configurable to your liking. So then, can we anticipate the same with all the following recovery potions? Well, yes, but actually, no. The hunger potion here will cost you 3 seeds, a morsel, and a carrot. But while you will still get a recovery potion, yes, said potion itself will not only spoil eventually, but also restores but 15 hunger overall. Furthermore, we can't expect the same 20-second cooldown between uses, unless settings are adjusted. But the hunger potion is also the only one to spoil out of all the brews you will see here today. So I wouldn't worry about it all that much. So we've had health and we've had hunger. So now it makes sense that we would have sanity, right? Right. And it's going to cost you 3 petals, a cut reed, and a blue shroom to brew. So get to it. Now, the sanity potion restores sanity. Duh. But do note that it will also drain 3 hunger from you each time you use it as well. The potion only restores 15 sanity every 20 seconds, so it's not overly enticing if I'm honest, but just tweak the stats to your liking, of course. However, from the sane to the insane, everybody. The insanity potion will cost you 3 dark petals, a cut reed, and 1 green mushroom for a brew that not only knocks you for 50 sanity each slurp, it is one that doesn't have a cooldown to boot. The only potion that doesn't have a cooldown, mind you. Very nice. Honestly, just tweaking the cooldowns of most of the potions in this mod is going to go a super long way to making it even better. But have fun going cuckoo, or have fun setting the world on fire with the fire potion. Now, we enter into the specialty potion territory here. A fire potion will set you back some ash, silk, and a red gem. But what exactly is it gonna do for ya? Well, a couple things actually. The potion is the first to show off this mod's particle effects, and with such, some flames are going to be shooting out from your body. The potion will also raise our temperatures by 40 points for 40 seconds, and the biggest thing, it will cause mobs that hit you to burst in the flames at a 20% chance, and is going to last you for 60 seconds. Not bad, but make note that this will not work on bosses of any caliber. So we have had fire. What about ice? The ice potion will cost 3 ice, a chunk of nitre, and 1 blue gem. But I bet you can't actually guess what it's gonna do at the end of the day. And that's mostly because there might be a glitch in the matrix, as they say. Sure, the potion lasts for 60 seconds, as the fire one does. Sure, it actually lowers our temperatures instead of raising them this time around. And sure, it has a 20% chance to freeze attackers. However, it seems that there's also some residual heat in this brew, because mobs may or may not both be completely frozen and on fire at the same time, which is actually really funny. Cool stuff, and all in good fun. But you know what's not fun? Charlie. So how about a potion to tell her to piss off? The light potion is quite expensive for what it does, if I'm honest, because for 3 light bulbs, 1 electrical doodad, and 1 bone shard of all things, you get a potion that, when drunk, gives you the equivalent light radius of a mere torch. Yeah, this mod is absolutely great, but certainly needs a few tweaks in that configuration menu we keep mentioning. So, just do it, because you know what? We can actually change the radius of this very brew. Very nice. But speed. I am speed. Chalk over some rather random materials like moonrock, fireflies, and jet feathers for a potion that increases our overall movement speeds by 20%, at least by default, that is. And yep, it's just that simple, everyone. But as we know, speed is very much key in this game, so any opportunity to get more of it should be taken immediately. Oh, and it will stack with all other speed boosts to boot. But what isn't quite so simple is the strength potion, everyone. Mostly because it doesn't actually work, unfortunately. For you see, drinking one is supposed to increase our overall damage by 10%. But it actually decreases our strength by 90%. Whoops. Obviously, not what was intended. But it's the thought that counts. However, while we may not have more offensive capabilities, I for one can always appreciate a better defense. The defense potion costs 3 cutstone, a pig butt, and 1 gold, and will reduce all incoming damages by an additional 10%, at least again at default levels. For example, instead of taking 10 damage from a tree guardian with a football helmet atop your noggin, you will be taking just under 9 damage with the potion active. Not too much, but again, adjustable. Easy peasy, and I wouldn't just stand there getting bonked anyways, you numpties. Unfortunately though, folks, I do have to say that yet another potion is done broken currently. The electric potion here is supposed to have it where attackers would have a 50% chance to take 5 damage when they hit you, with wet targets receiving 3 times that damage, but it doesn't appear to function properly as things stand. Once more though, I love the idea, and the damages are adjustable to your liking. Plus, the really cool thing is that this potion can be used to overcharge WX78 players when they drink it. Very cool. And the last potion of the day is this guy right here. The Mysterious Potion. Costing 3 monster meat, wet goop of all things, and rot. The Mysterious Potion can spawn a set of frogs nearby, spawn in a wide assortment of random items right on top of ya, spawn flowers perhaps, call down lightning, put you and other nearby mobs to sleep, spawn fires around you, or heck, even put you on ice. You name it, this thing could probably do it. Cause here's the thing, the Mysterious Potion has 41 random effects that it can pull from for each use. So, I guess you just gotta keep drinking it to experience them all. And there you have it, everyone. Felix's Fancy Potions. I love me some potion brewing, and this mod simply solidifies that love. So thank you once again, Felix, for everything you have done. And be sure to show your thanks, everyone, as well, by not only checking out this mod here today, but all of his 11 other works to boot. And many thanks to Hunts and Neutral as well. Appreciate you guys watching, folks. Well wishes to ya. Stay safe out there. Appreciate life. And I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.